Just imagine if you are living in a place where it is a relatively a poor state, a poor village. For your bhajan, you make a nice place for yourself. You know, there is a water body, everything is there, nice garden is there. Your garden is beautiful, but rest everybody has nothing and you are absorbed in your bhajan. How can you be absorbed in your bhajan? It is not possible only. It is impossible to be absorbed. Then you have to force yourself. Oh, this is all mundane, this is all mundane. You have to be conscious of trying to say this is all mundane, I don't need to distract myself. But rather than, in fact, by saying that this is all mundane, you are simply saying, you know, I don't care, I'm desensitized, it is none of my business. But we don't see that. We don't see that, you know, Lord Chaitanya, Srila Prabhupada also, when he saw somebody poor, he said, all right, nobody in and around for 5 kilometers go hungry. Yes, giving food is not the ultimate goal of any sadhu. You know, but at the same time, not giving food when there is an emergency for somebody is also not a nature of sadhu.
Yes, that's true.
Giving water is not his mission, but giving water in emergency is a human sensitivity, maturity, and knowledge. He doesn't say, oh, because they're starving, they're need water, so therefore I will build so many water tanks. I will no more engage in devotional service, because giving water itself is bhakti. So it's a common sense. It's a very common sense. Yeah.
That's true. So basically, if you consider, say, giving water or providing like building wells or something like that, that is an activity of expanded consciousness. So a sadhu, their primary activity is elevating their consciousness.
Yes.
Sadhu won't spend one's life to doing activities of expanded consciousness primarily. But it's not that they're against it. In an emergency, we'll do it. But if somebody starts thinking that, so I think when Prabhupada sometimes critiques, like say, Manav Seva hi Madhav Seva hai, Manav Seva is Madhav Seva, his critique is not so much that Manav Seva is bad, but to equate the two is the problem. To think that we don't need to do any worship of God just because we are doing social service. That is the problem. Both have their place, and sadhus are going to do the elevation of consciousness.
And that is, again, another one. Another one is that they not only equate, they undermine the service to the Supreme.
Yes.
No? Yeah. Like when we say, when there is a whole concept of Shraddha ceremony, there are Rishi Rina, there is Pitri Rina, there is Deva Rina, and there is Bhuta Rina. So when I offer food to the devas and rishis and pitris, so this so-called socialist, they'll say, hey, why are you wasting all your money? Garibon ko khila. It is but natural for somebody who's practicing proper spirituality, he will also do bhuta runa, because it's connected to the society, will also do that. But to say this is against this, this is against that, that is not correct. There is a great integration in the life of a real yogi. No?
Oh, okay.
He can handle them. Therefore, he harmonizes the swadharma. He harmonizes that with swarupa dharma, and he harmonizes that apad dharma. Giving water for somebody thirsty in a desert-like a place for a sadhu, he is apad dharma. He doesn't say, oh, this is against my swarup dharma. I don't give water, therefore I don't want to do any mundane charity. If he has to think like that, that means he's not a sadhu only. He has to take the philosophy of spirituality to avoid an emergency duty for some poor person. That means he's bringing philosophy at the wrong place. He doesn't need a bhajan place. He needs some counseling required.
Yeah, you know, our philosophy actually is, our spirituality is meant to build on our humanity, not diminish our humanity.
You don't have to be even thinking about it. It's spontaneous. I remember one of the greatest of the sannyasis, one who passed away, Pejar Swamiji. Now, who can worship the Lord more than him? He took sannyas when he was 8 years old. And he left his body when he was 85 years old. Every Ekadashi practiced Nirjal. Every Chaturmasi did. every day worshipped his deity without fail. Since he got his deity worship till he became sick, last few days he did not. One time he was coming to the temple during his pariyaya, that means worshipping the deity. He would always be up early morning. He came at 3:30 instead of 4:15 to the temple. He could have come at 4 o'clock, 4:15, but he came little early to chant his rounds in the temple complex, then go inside the altar to worship. But he saw the guard sleeping there. So rather than waking up the guard thinking, "Arey, I'm coming for the deity worship, but you're sleeping here," he walked back to his ashram. Then he came at 4:15. And the guard was up also.
Oh God.
If I was a pujari, when I heard this story, you know, in my consciousness, I would feel I am doing something superior and is in mode of tamo and disturb him from his sleep. You know, somebody asked, "Oh, is it allowed?" You don't have to go to Jeev Goswami to quote whether we should give water to some poor person or not in emergency. You don't need the approval of the great acharyas. You know, if you are looking for an approval for the great acharyas to give water, the acharyas will feel very embarrassed that I need to speak about this thing also.
You know, Prabhupada often said Krishna consciousness is common sense, but often sometimes we just, this is not even common sense, it's actually decency or basic humanity. So we maybe overlook that in the name of being spiritual. So I think this is a very interesting diversion, but we'll come back to our subject.
Yeah, it is connected to racism only. Racism is also based upon basically how can you not be sensitive to someone who may be completely different from you. Completely different from you. How can you feel, how is it possible to feel, he does not deserve my kindness because he's not part of my race. It is a screwed up consciousness. It cannot be natural. It has been brainwashed. So okay. Organized racism is nothing but brainwashed to believe in something which you don't believe in your core of the heart.